Hi everyone, welcome to my channel. This is Quantum Unicorn. If this is your first time tuning into my program, I want to let you know that all the demos and data files in my program are free to download. You can find these files by clicking the link below the video. If you are a returning viewer, I hope you have taken my advice and spent some time practicing the code we covered in our last video. And just a kind reminder, this course is meant for educational purposes only. The data and information presented in this video is not investment advice, okay? And please subscribe to my channel, like the video, and click the bell icon on to receive the latest updates. Thank you! And today, we are going to delve into the variability of the sample mean and its corresponding distribution. Understanding the principles of variation is crucial in enabling us to accurately evaluate estimations and validate assertions concerning populations based on samples. For instance, let us consider a scenario where historical data for 100 days is available. We can calculate the sample mean and variance of the stock returns. Based on these statistics, can we make inferences regarding the parameters? To what extent are the statistics close to population parameters? Can we assert from observing stock data for 100 days that the stock is experiencing an upward trend, or implying that the mean return is positive? Our comprehension of the sample mean distribution is vital in answering all these questions. Look at the cell here. In this case, we randomly sample 30 observations from a population with a normal distribution, where the mean equals 10 and the standard deviation equals 5. Running this cell multiple times would result in different outcomes. The variance of the samples is known as the variation of the sample, which is due to the random selection of samples from a normal distribution. Moreover, the sample mean and standard deviation are not arbitrary. They follow specific rules as they are extracted from the same population. In this code, we generate 1,000 samples from the same population, obtaining the mean and the variance for each sample, which we save in a data frame collection. The mean list stores the sample means for the 10,000 samples, while the var list preserves the sample variances for the same number of samples. We then use a loop to generate 10,000 samples, computing the mean and variance for each sample and saving them in the respective lists. After that, in the following cell, we create an empty data frame, which we name collection, to which we add the same mean list and var list to different columns. We can then create a histogram of the sample means, which appears symmetric and resembles a normal distribution. On the other hand, the histogram for the sample variance is not normal, as it is right skewed. It is possible to infer and even mathematically prove that the sample mean is normal distributed if the population is normal with the mean of mu and a variance of sigma squared. Then the sample mean is also normal with a mean equal to mu and a variance equal to sigma squared divided by the sample size m. Why is the variance of the sample mean smaller than the variance of the population? Well, intuitively, the sample mean is the average of n individuals from the population. Hence, the variation of the sample mean is smaller than the variation of individuals in the population. The Python code provided here demonstrates this concept. The blue histogram represents the population, while the red one depicts the sample mean. But what if the population is not normal? According to the central limit theorem of statistics, if the sample size is large enough, the distribution of sample means resembles a normal distribution. Thus, we can conclude that even if the population is not normal, the sample is approximately normal if the sample size is large enough. Here, we provide an example of the distribution of sample means when the population is not normal. Next, we use the data frame named APOP to store the population, which comprises five values of 1 and 0. With a for loop, we generate 100k samples with a small sample size of 10, and the resulting histogram for sample means does not appear to be a normal distribution. However, if we generate 100k samples with a large sample size of 2000, the distribution of sample mean now looks like a normal distribution. In this video, we focused on the distribution of sample mean and the probability rule of variation of sample mean. We will apply these concepts in the upcoming videos to explore two important quantitative statistical tools, confidence interval and hypothesis testing. All right, that concludes our content for today. I really hope you guys got the hang of it. If you are feeling confused or frustrated about any of the code we showed in the program, please don't stress. I will go over the ins and outs of every line of code in the next episode, so we will get you up to speed in no time. And if any of the financial theories or statistical concepts we talked about are still a bit of a mystery to you, just drop me a comment. I am more than happy to give you some extra content or examples to help you out. And speaking of comments, I'm always open to your feedback and suggestions. So if you have got any thoughts on how we can make this program even better, please don't be shy about sharing them. Oh, and if you haven't already, I would love it if you could subscribe to my channel to stay updated on my latest videos. And if you have friends or family who would also appreciate the knowledge of building stock trading models in Python, please feel free to share my videos with them. I truly appreciate your support, and I'm excited to continue sharing more tutorials with you on my channel. Thank you again for your time, and I look forward to catching you all in the next episode. Goodbye.